this kind of a division for PDE-based and abstract controller design is of course very general and it can be applied to many different control problems, but I still want to spend a little bit of time discussing this division and these two approaches in the context of the robust output regulation problem. So beginning with the PDE-based approach, we already saw that if we start out with our PDE model, we can figure out what kind of an internal model that we need and what kind of a structure for the controller would guarantee this for us. And then we can add some kind of, for example, PDE-based observer design in order for closed loop to achieve the closed loop stability and arrive at a PDE controller which solves the robust output regulation problem. On the other hand, in the abstract route, we would begin with our original PDE and first find a representation in a suitable class of abstract systems. And once we have this abstract representation of our PDE model, ideally we have access to a large number of different types of controller designs which can be applied to this class of models. And these results typically come together with the kind of a general structure for the controller that we are designing, along with some kind of instructions on how to choose the controller parameters. And starting from PDE models, it's typical that the problem of choosing these parameters correctly can be converted into some kind of PDE stabilization problems and so on. But after we have applied our abstract controller design, we're left with typically a controller which is also an abstract system living on some infinite dimensional vector space. And if our original goal is to get some kind of a PDE type controller, we should still need to do some kind of interpretation to convert our PDE dynamic abstract controller into a system with PDE dynamics. And at least visually, the abstract route here seems a little bit longer. So it's a relevant question what kind of benefits and disadvantages this has compared to the design of controllers just for individual PDE models. And the first real benefit of this abstract route is that once we have reached the representation of our PDE as an abstract system, then there's a variety of ready-made controller designs which can be used ideally almost like black box in order to solve the robust output regulation problem. The only sort of part here being the tuning and choosing of the controller parameters. So this kind of use of ready-made structures especially guarantees the internal model structure of the controller and some kind of additional structure which can be used in the closed-loop stabilization. So especially if we're interested in solving the output regulation problem for several different PDE models, this can help a lot in reducing repetition when we don't need to start coming up with the internal model type structures from scratch every time we consider a new PDE model. And especially due to the internal model's principle, the robust output regulation problem has a lot of this structure which can be exploited in a very efficient way in this kind of abstract controller design, where we can introduce controllers where this general structure already guarantees the internal model property for our controller, and the additional structure can be used in the stabilization problem. Then finally, the choosing of these open and free controller parameters can be converted efficiently into PDE stabilization problems, where we can again benefit from the deep knowledge of our original PDE system. On the other hand, the abstract approach also has its downsides. And one of the first ones relates to this first step in the process, because converting a PDE model into an abstract differential equation can, in many cases, require fairly detailed knowledge of the abstract systems theory, and it can be still challenging. But the good news is that for a lot of large classes of important PDEs, like diffusion equations, wave equations, beam equations, with boundary control and distributed control, this representation may already be known. So there's a lot of results in the literature that can be used in helping with this first step. On the other hand, also in the last step, converting the abstract controller into a PDE controller can similarly require some effort and knowledge of the abstract systems design. And I think this is one part which hasn't been studied so much in the literature, but I think there's a lot of things to do in making this step easier in the process. But somehow still the take-home message is, even in the abstract approach, is that if we start out with a PDE model that we want to control and proceed this abstract route into an abstract controller, then the controller dynamics do still correspond to some kind of a PDE model. So there's no magic conversion happening so that we would for some reason end up with a radically different type of controller than our original PDE model. And the obvious question then is, when should we choose one of these routes over another? So when should we choose or use the abstract approach? And this is typically in the situation where the conversions between the PDE model and the abstract systems are relatively easy and effortless. And this happens especially in the case where the PDE has distributed inputs and outputs, irregardless of the spatial domains, because in this situation, the distributed parameter representation is usually fairly straightforward to come up with. Another relevant situation is when our PDE has a one-dimensional spatial domain, because the vast majority of these kinds of PDE models, even with boundary control and observation, still are relatively well known in the literature, and they can be represented using existing results as abstract linear systems. Moreover, even on multidimensional domains, especially the parabolic PDE models like convection, diffusion, reaction equations can often be represented as regular linear systems due to existing results in the literature. And finally, even if we're outside the scope of these regular linear systems, if our system is exponentially stable and externally well posed, then there's a very simple controller design, which is actually an old finite dimensional controller, which can be used in solving the robust output regulation problem. On the other hand, there are also still situations where I would recommend just working with the individual PDE. And this is especially the case if we're considering boundary control and observation of a PDE with multidimensional spatial domain, which is not does not belong to the class of parabolic systems. And in this situation, the coming up with the abstract representation can really be challenging. And also in general, if the system is not externally well posed, then it's also possible that there are no abstract results that could be used for this particular class of systems. Okay, so we can now consider a particular PDE example and see how the abstract approach in controller design works. So let's consider a pure heat equation on a rectangular domain. And the system has Neumann boundary conditions, having a boundary input at the bottom edge, part of the bottom edge of the spatial domain. And the measured temperature is the temperature average on the top edge of the rectangle. And finally, we have an external disturbance signal entering from the left. And this PDE is unstable due to the Neumann boundary conditions, so it has a zero eigenvalue. And in addition, we can see clearly that the inputs and the outputs are non-collocated. So our first step in the abstract controller design is to figure out what kind of a class of systems is appropriate for our PDE model. There's existing results on these types of models by Burns, Gilliam, and Weiss from the early 2000s, which give us the opportunity to represent our PDE as a so-called regular linear system. So the existing results tell us that the heat equation can be represented as a distributed parameter system on the L2 space over the rectangular domain. And here the input and output operators are unbounded. But actually, for this controller design method, it's not necessary to know explicitly what the input and output operators are. But instead, we can go through the design process of the controller based on simply the knowledge that this kind of a representation exists. And because we're in the regular linear systems class, there are existing results on solvability and controller design for robust output regulation. And the good news here is that our heat equation does have both of these properties, and this is just checkable from our PDE model. So this means that we can go into the step two of our controller design, which is the abstract controller design. And for this, we have a few options available. And this controller has two parts, one of them being a finite dimensional linear differential equation determined, whose dynamics are determined by matrices G1 and G2. And the other part is an infinite dimensional linear system on the space X. And this has the form of a kind of a Leuenberger type observer, and it's used in the achieving the closed loop stabilization. So this controller has an explicit form, and its parameters are these G1 and G2, as well as these bounded operators L, K1 and K2. So what is left to do in this controller design process is to find these values for these open parameters. And considering the kinds of reference and disturbance signals that we do with our known frequencies and unknown amplitudes and phases, the matrices G1 and G2 can actually be constructed explicitly just based on the information about the frequencies in the signals, as well as the number of independent outputs, which in our case is equal to 1. And these matrices G1 and G2 actually contain the internal model of our controller. And the rest of the parameters of the system are then chosen in such a way that the closed loop system will be stable. And there's a tuning method for these parameters. In particular, the operator L should be chosen in such a way that the system under output injection is exponentially stable. And the last two parameters are chosen to achieve feedback stabilization for a cascade system consisting of part of the plant together with this internal model ODE part. And in order to achieve the stability of both these systems, there are several alternatives available from our heat equation system. One approach is to use the system fact that our abstract system represents a heat equation to rewrite both of these systems as stabilization problems for the PDE and a PDE-ODE cascade. But because we're dealing with a heat equation, it's possible to use Galerkin type approximations like finite elements to in order to design these parameters L and K using the solutions of finite dimensional linear quadratic control methods. And this is especially due to Banks and Ito from 97. Alternatively, more generally, even for non-parabolic systems, it's possible to explicitly stabilize the ladder cascade system using the so-called forwarding approach, which deals with stabilization of cascades. And as shown in our explored in our very recent work with Jukka-Pekka Humaloja, it's also possible to combine numerics with the forwarding approach to reduce this stabilization of this cascade to solving a finite number of boundary value problems related to the original PDE system. So when these parameters are chosen, we have an abstract controller. So in the last step, we would also like to find a PDE version of this controller. And this is something that I looked into with Jukka-Pekka Humaloja just this year and investigated how this last step can be done in a rigorous manner. And using these results, it is indeed possible to determine the corresponding PDE controller corresponding to which solves the robust output regulation problem. And in this PDE controller, we still have the same ODE part as in our original abstract controller, but now the state of the infinite dimensional part is instead a weak solution of a PDE model, which is of similar type as our original heat equation on the rectangle. So this indeed concludes our abstract path, where we've started with a PDE controller, proceeded via the abstract domain to find some kind of a controller, and then made our way back from the abstract domain to the PDE world to arrive at a final PDE type controller. We can also do numerical simulations to verify that our controller work, even though these, of course, use numerical approximations. And at this point, it's perhaps relevant to advertise that in our group, we have developed a fully featured MATLAB and Python toolboxes for control design for robust output regulation. And in particular, this ROR pack includes high-level routines for constructing internal model-based controllers, and you can choose different ways of tuning the controller parameters. And you also have routines for simulating the closed-loop system behavior and visualizing your results for several types of different PDE test cases that I've already implemented in the package, and we're adding more as we explore different PDEs as well. And all of this you can find in GitHub as open source. So this